the big first movie, the first Purge. I love dystopian fiction, but this is just ridiculous. I'm Andrew Langer here on WBAL News Radio 1090.
From Baltimore's largest radio news team, this is WBAL News Radio 1090.
Sunny skies, 77 degrees at 9:30. Good morning, I'm Bill Zanko. Here's the latest from the WBAL 24-hour broadcast center. Protests are planned in Scotland today against President Trump, who's spending the weekend at his golf resort there. The BBC said shortly after we got there yesterday, a paraglider was seen flying close to the resort with a banner that read, Trump well below par. A large protest held in Glasgow on Friday. More protests expected today at Trump's golf courses in Scotland and at the Scottish Parliament in Edinburgh. The president is at that golf course preparing for a summit meeting with Vladimir Putin on Monday. Also spending some time tweeting new attacks on CNN and the Russian investigation, which is still cause of witch hunt, even after a dozen Russians were indicted yesterday and charged with hacking the election. We're celebrating the cave rescue of that young soccer team in Thailand by inviting the survivors to the soccer group's annual awards event this fall. Originally, they invited the 12 boys and their coach to the World Cup final in Moscow on Sunday. Doctors couldn't give them travel okays, though, so instead they'll be invited to London. The doctors, meanwhile, say the boys could be released from the hospital sometime this week. And the 181st ranked women's tennis player in the world will play for the Women's Wimbledon Championship today. Maybe you've heard of her.
That is completely over the top in their attacks on president willing to abuse a whole host of organs of state power in order to get them. That's a problem. You have a news media willing to lie about this problem. That's a problem. And we just sort of drum this up, the hysteria being created over border security, the comparison of immigration detention facilities to concentration camps. That's the thing that causes the Civil War. Not the president saying that Vladimir Putin's a great man. And just in the same way, and I'm going to engage in what about is in here. In the same way that Barack Obama talking about Vladimir Putin has been more flexible